jacket opens up, and you reach, you take out. It's loaded. Okay? And it's that fast. And it's, you, all you're ostensibly doing is reaching into the pocket, taking out your wallet. It's, there's no fumbling or anything. Okay, this is pulled out. Now, before it was held like this. Yeah, sure. Let me swing over here. Before, when it was done, or it was in the notes, it was, you, the guy was on the back. So your hand came up over the top, and it had to try to hit that guy in the back. My God, you could hit the pocket on the inside. There's so many different things you could hit. It was impossible. And I gave up on the effect. And so what Ortiz says, put it in the front, like this. Now, when you're first starting, you'll hear clicks, two clicks. You have your palm here, excuse me, hold here. This goes in this position, and as you come up, you hear two clicks. You hear the click of the jacket, and then you hear the click here. So it's click, click, and then down, and it's that fast. So if you have a dark enough jacket, you can open this way and do it. You're sitting down, so I know my angle is bad as I've gone up. If you're standing up, you might see the card go in. Your hand just comes up and it goes like that. That's it. And here, yeah. It's, sure. Okay. Palm here. See the little part here? So you just jump up. It's done.
Slow motion.
All right. Okay. So the guide is in the front. That's all it is. Okay? Now, your hand just comes up, hits, just pushes it down. It's in the front. That's it. Your hand comes out. So you go, boom, boom, out. So what they're seeing is this. That's all it is. Believe me, it is that fast, and it takes a little practice. No, the loading doesn't take any practice. It's going to take your practice, just palm you up apart. The load is just so darn simple. Just comes up and just jams in. Listen for the clicks the first two times. After a while, you get used to it. You know just where it is, and just come in, bam, hit the pocket lid.
Show us the one hand palm.
Yeah. Where is that? In the.
It's quad manipulation.
Is that okay? Yeah. Your hand, I found out this, okay? For me anyway, and I don't care if there are people here who can do it straight on and not move these fingers. It doesn't make a bit of difference because you're gesturing anyway. When I tell them to, my favorite one, sir, would you please stand up here? Okay, my favorite one is, sir, would you point to any cards you like in the deck? Jack of Hearts. Now, you notice the Jack of Hearts is in the center of the deck. There are no questions, no prints, breaks, crap, those wires, mirrors, rocks, balls, screws, and that puts pencil, pens, caps, tape, safe, depends on your seal system. I'm going to give you a deck of cards. I want you to shuffle them up. But I tell you this, if you get shit of shuffling your deck of cards, from instantaneously you're going to find your cards. It's not impossible. I say this. Give the cards a shuffle. Okay? Let's start. Okay, now, just sit down a second. The point, I'm not getting to the top. The point is, you're talking, you're gesturing, and I don't do it. I do it as I start to hand the cards though. Your hand comes here, it palms it off. It is another little thing, too. You have to either, Diggle does it this way. He bends the fingers in, all right? Which adds a nice bit to it, because it doesn't look like it. So he hands you the cards this way, okay? Instead of palming the card off like this and holding it like this, or coming over to the edge. This little bending of the finger makes it very, very interesting, okay? It makes it very look very, very good, but it doesn't look like you have a card palmed here, okay? So. The only thing I tell you, though, that is that I have to take these three fingers have to revolve just a little bit as this finger stays straight. And as it's these revolve just a little bit, that will tip that a corner up, okay? It takes a lot of practice. It does take, sit in front of your TV set hour after hour, just practice till it comes. And then it just instantaneously, it'll just pop out, okay? That's one way of loading. There's another way of two. I don't know if you're familiar with this. Put the card back in deck. Do you know how to mix cards up? Okay, that's another one. You know, the regular 10 card out of the deck. All right. So Diggle does it straight on. He takes the card, pushes it in, comes forward, and hands you the card. And this is the here. I prefer coming here and doing the straightening up. In other words, straightening up the cards, so to speak. So you're putting, ostensibly you put the card in, square it up, and you square the deck up. But what you're doing is you're kicking the card over, hand comes down to square this portion, comes back up, this squares this, and I hand it right to the person. There's nothing for you to see, is there?
No.
No. I mean, you're completely covered. And they just, they take, reach in and take the card. They take it right out and you're, okay? So that's another way. But I prefer in the center and bring it to the top, okay? Am I going too fast? Another thing, work with higher the rain. Am I too fast? No, okay. All right. Another interesting thing I might talk to you about. Cigarette through the quarter. I think a lot of people are afraid of it because they have to handle two coins. And I'll tell you the truth. I watched Varick do it for, I guess, about 5 years. And I never wanted to handle it. Why? Because I don't like to do tricks that only work 95% of the time. And you get caught. I hate being caught, even though it's only that 1 or 5 or 2 or 3% of the time. And I always, and as well as he hit it, when you're doing cigarette through the quarter, and you've done it once, you've done it twice, by that time, you've got people on the floor looking up here that they're all over top of you. And it's very difficult to work doing that, and even does it as well, it gets picked off. And then I happen to catch, the chop cup routine. Who's the chop cup guy?
Don Allen.
Don Allen came up and I said, oh my God, he solved the whole problem. And let me just show it to you. You don't have to use this. You can use the pencil like Michael Moore does. Mike uses my switch. I think he's ridiculous because I don't know. Harry talked me into one. I don't know how he came up with it. I probably stole it from somebody in my sleep. And I think it's takeoff from somebody else. Mike does it like, and I find it just, it's not really necessary when you're doing cigarettes through the quarter. Does anybody have a cigarette? It's very difficult nowadays to find somebody a cigarette. But, Carrie, oh, I got it. Thank you, Gary. One. He's Canadians. Wow. Look at that. Okay. And this is, I think, is very, very clever. You borrow a cigarette, okay, and this gentleman will have the quarter, this gentleman will have the cigarette. The cigarette is always picked up first. Okay, it's acting more than anything else. Cigarette is picked up, and I usually prefer working with a young lady because of Derek's lines. And we'll just assume, sir, that you're a pretty young lady. I then reach for the quarter, and I say, may I have the quarter, please? And would you hold your hand out, and I put in the gimmick quarter, and I need matches, and this goes south. I do not have any coin in my hand but the gimmick quarter. Now, I laid that in their hand. Now, the question is, are they ever going to turn that coin over? I do that effect at least 50 times a week. At least 50 times a week. I have never, I repeat, I have never had anybody ever turn that coin over. You ask to repeat it, they still don't turn that coin over. Now, I have one little thing that I do with it. I do take the cigarette, and I do place it over the top of the coin so that in case they ever did, you want to examine the coin, so they have to take the cigarette off and I reach for the coin. I've always caution myself, but now it's they just don't, I'm so brave, I can walk over here, can I borrow the matches? I know they're not going to turn the coin over. And the steel and the change is, let me show you how lazy I've gotten. I used to keep the gimmick coin between these two fingers. And then I would borrow the coin from a person here, go into a palm here and place this one in, okay? So you had to use a palm. You had to be able to palm a coin. Not necessary. All you do is you reach over, you take this coin, you hold it with these two fingers, you put this other one in, it just stays in your hand, that's all. Here's the coin, I put the cigarette on top, I need a match. Oh yeah, there's the match. I'm done. I have no gimmick. I mean, I don't have no gimmick there. I don't have any other coin in my hand. How do you get away with it? When you do all the patter-patter at the end, you turn to the person. I've done it through 3 or 4 times. Usually with the young lady, it doesn't make a difference. It works with a gentleman too. But you, Dingle's line of, say, miss, This, you got to finish it, pull out about three or four times. I want to tell you this. This is not an ordinary coin. This is a magic coin. It performs magic. So you take this coin, you go home tonight, you put this under your pillow. And if you're good, and only if you're good, good fairy's going to visit you. I'll be there at 10. And don't lock the door because I'm melting beef. Okay? Great lines. You do it with a guy, you just have to act a little more, you know? Okay? And then, here's what you do. Here's the gimmick coin. And you're going to give it to you. You say, oh, well, before I do, can I ask you one question? Did you really think there was a coin with a lot of sugar to pass through? And the person says no. And you say, you're right for the first time. There is no such coin. Now, let me tell you why that is so good. I always wear the dark shade because I'm too lazy to put my contacts on. And whenever I watched Derek do it, even if he didn't get caught, I would see the person in the back going, I wonder if it's the same coin. Now, when I tried this with Don, with Dan on this, that's interesting. Let me try it that way. I look with the dark glasses. There's nothing. I've asked lots of people, why am I suspecting another coin? He said, because you've done a different trick at the end. I've talked to a couple of people, and this is some of the explanation. They said, and now you've matched the coin, it's a different trick. And he just assumed it's a regular coin. I don't know what the answer is. I don't get that question of, gee, was it a gimmick coin? At the end, I just vanish the coin. I use this, and I don't know where I get this up. It's the only time I use it because I don't like to move. You just reach here, and this pivots around, and it goes into palm, get the cigarette, go like that, and it's gone. There is no such coin. And I find it very, very strong. One of the strongest I get asked for it to do.
Yeah. Right. Did you follow the coin?
Yes.
Did you follow the coin?
I always, oh, yeah, but I never give the quarter back. Never.
That's the secret of success.
Never give. No, I'll tell you what. Watch what happens when somebody says, what about my quarter? Somebody says, you ain't worth a quarter, you cheapo, shut up. The crowd takes care of it. Let me tell you, you want a great one, and I don't. You want a. Yes, I do. I didn't realize this. I'll give this away. Somebody, does anybody have a cigarette light? You really need a cigarette light. Does anybody have a cigarette light? Gary, do you have a cigarette lighter? Yes, you will.
Is it worth the cigarette lighter?
Yeah, this is great. This is a great. It's a great little opening. It's a great little opening. Say, before I start, can I borrow a dollar bill from somebody here, please? Let me have a dollar bill I can borrow. I need to borrow because you'll see why in a second. I've been asked to make a public service announcement. Very, very, very good. Yes. You see, when I came up here today, and I just got off the thruway, I was stopped by the police chief there, and he saw that my license plate says Conjure in the car. He says, are you going out to Bellagio with all the great magicians? I said, yes, I am. He said, would you tell him to be careful up there? Because there's an influx of counterfeit dollar bills in the area. I said, you're kidding. He says, no, this is truthfully. You have influx of counterfeit dollar bills. So when you're up there, could you warn them, be careful when they exchange money? I said, gee, not only that, I'll show them how to tell the difference between a real dollar bill and a counterfeit one. Don't worry about the ink, the electric plate, the texture of the paper. No. What you do to find out if a bill is genuine is, look, you fold it once. This is called the fourfold. You fold it once. You fold it twice. You fold it three times. Crease all the edges. And then you get the cigarette lighter and you do this. And if that happens, that's a good bill. That bill is real. Does anybody have a 20? I get beautiful. Okay. Now, I tell you, that is a great little bit. And the reason I mentioned about the quarters was because every time, I always opened up, I do a lot of shows for the elderly out there, a lot of benefit shows for the elderly. And I always open with this and I explain to them, you know, careful about your money, et cetera, et cetera. And then I like the bill and I say, when it goes up, you see, and that bill's good, that's a good bill. And they all in hysterics. Because this guy lost the bill. I say, anybody got a 20? And the reason I'm mentioning this, I go home at nighttime, I take my clothes off, and I start cleaning out my pockets, and there's the dollar bill. I forgot to give the dollar bill back. Now, I've done this for years, so what I did, after a while I said, you know what, I forget, and of course this person thinks I burnt the bill. That's why I didn't ask him. I said, this tell me if he burnt my bill. He got a laugh out of it, he burnt my bill. So you know what I did? I said, let me switch to a 10. Because when I switch to a 10, then if I forget, you know, the guy's going to ask me for the 10. I do it with the 10. I go home that night, I reach my pocket, and here's the $10 bill. The dummy thought I burnt his $10 bill. So I switched back to singles again because of the fact if I and I still go home, and here's the dollar bill there. I know I forgot. I feel a little bad about it. But not with the quarters, so that was the reason I said it. I know. Okay. Well, what's the deli? That's another interesting. Does anybody have, can I borrow that for a second? Let me show you something. This is, Micah Marr just came out with his new book. And if anything in there is worth something, it's worth the $100 bill switch. And he has a little something on there that is sensational. And that's this. Okay, look. Every time you get a bill, now this one is creased fairly good, so there's no problem. But a lot of times you get a bill that crinkled up, and to try to make that fold good, you're going to have problems. And you're sitting there, you're trying to do the fold. So Mike has a way of doing it. He gets in with first saying, I'm going to show you an effect that I learned when I was a kid. It was taught to us by the teachers in school. Okay? And it was, you probably know it, but I'm going to do it for you. It's called the threefold. And he's pattering this way because he's going to fold the bill and use the threefold to make this bill exactly the way he wants it. So he says, look, you notice the portrait of George Washington's face up? You see, I know you know this, but let me show you. Look, I fold it once. It's a nice fold on it. He says, I fold it twice. It's a nice fold on it. I fold it three times. Now he's folded. Now he says, and when I open it, look, he's upside down. Now he's folded the bill. Right. But no big deal. No big deal. We all learned that when we were kids. What they didn't teach us was the fourfold. Okay? Now actually, my wife taught me the fourfold. And the reason she taught me the fourfold is because, you see, she's a lovely woman. Now, don't get me wrong, she's a lovely woman. But when I married my wife Happy, and most of you know her, when I married Happy, I said, honey, if I ever were broke, would you still love me? You know what she said, God bless? She said, of course I'd love you.